Hey, welcome back. If you have trouble loading web pages using your Wi-Fi on your wireless device, or your Wi-Fi keeps cutting out, then please watch this video. So I bought a new wireless G and N combination router. After connecting it, we had problems right away. Mostly connection issues and difficulties loading web pages on our wireless devices from some places within our house. Our cell phones, laptops, and gaming devices were all affected. The following steps led me to a proper solution. Using my Android phone, I installed a free app from the market called Wi-Fi Analyzer. Then I scanned my home Wi-Fi network with my phone using that free app. This immediately showed me that even though my wireless G signal was very strong throughout my house, several of my neighbors' wireless G networks were all pushing their way into my house too, some with the same channel number as mine. This was a huge source of interference for me, as I probably was for them as well. Knowing this, I logged into my router and into the wireless 2.4 GHz section, where I then changed my channel settings from automatic to a manual channel selection, which appeared empty in the Wi-Fi Analyzer app I used. I rebooted my router and scanned my house again. I now had nobody else sharing my channel, and most importantly, those connection problems completely disappeared. Everything was fine again. Upon doing the same scan within the 5 GHz band, there were no other channels conflicting with mine. This does not mean that it won't happen in the future, though. Now, there is one very important thing to keep in mind here. Even though my router can simultaneously transmit on the 2.4 and 5 GHz bands, the 2.4 GHz frequency has the ability to travel easier through walls and obstructions than the 5 GHz can. As you can see here from a scan I did in our rec room downstairs. Since our devices will automatically connect to our stronger networks, this will lead to network slowdowns and stumbles if our neighbors' 2.4G signals at the same channel setting are mixing with ours. So there you go. If you have a wireless router, neighbors, and connection problems, you might want to think about doing what I did. You'll need to follow the instructions from your router's manufacturer if you want to make changes to your settings. Good luck, and hopefully you'll be able to save some time and aggravation. Until next time, check out my other videos, and thanks for watching.